An electrophilic addition of hydrogen bromide to an asymmetric alkene, in this case propene. You'll see in a moment why it's said to be asymmetric. It reacts with HBr to form either 1-bromopropane or 2-bromopropane, as you will see. So look in the middle here at the structure of propene, and you'll see why it's asymmetric. It's not symmetrical about the vertical axis. The left-hand carbon has two H's directly attached, the right-hand carbon has one H and a methyl attached. So here's the question, where is the H of the HBr going to go? Is it going to go on to the left-hand carbon? Because if it does, the bromine will go on the right-hand carbon and form 2-bromopropane. Whereas instead, if the H of the HBr goes on the right-hand carbon, that means the bromine will go on the left-hand carbon and we'll get 1-bromopropane. Markovnikov's rule helps us to predict the major product. That which has gets, referring to the fact that the carbon with the most H's directly attached, in this case the left-hand carbon, gets the incoming H of the HBr, and the bromine goes on the other. Let's look at this mechanism here. HBr is a polar molecule. Look at the change in electronegativity of elements in the periodic table. It increases from cesium in the bottom left up to fluorine in the top right. It increases as you go up a group and as you go across a period. Bromine, being much further to the right than hydrogen, is more electronegative. Look at the electrons here. They don't actually move like this, the blue around the hydrogen, the red around the bromine. This is how they actually move. The two electrons spend time around both atoms. Now, if the molecule was a homonuclear diatomic molecule, such as H2, Cl2, Br2, where the two atoms bonded are identical, they would spend their time around both atoms equally. But in this molecule, because bromine is more electronegative, which literally means it can pull electrons more strongly to it, they spend more of their time around the bromine atom in the molecule. So if you look, hopefully you'll notice that. And this means that we have to assign a small negative charge to the bromine atom, and we use the symbol delta from the Greek alphabet. So it's assigned a delta minus, and the hydrogen, which therefore has a slight electron deficiency, it's assigned a delta plus charge. We need to know this in order to appreciate why these molecules should come together and react in the first place. So the HBr molecule is said to be a dipole, di meaning two, so two poles. At the top we've got the delta plus pole, and the bottom the delta minus pole. I'd like you to look at the top now and watch how this carbon-carbon double bond in propene breaks. The two electrons in that pi bond between the two carbon atoms will move to form a bond with the H of the HBr. Now that means the right-hand carbon of the carbon-carbon double bond will lose out. It loses the electron it contributed to form the pi bond. So you'll notice it develops a positive charge. See how the carbon now on the left uses those two electrons of the pi bond form a bond with the H of the HBr. So just as quickly as the hydrogen atom of HBr loses a share in the pair of electrons with bromine, it gains a share in a pair of electrons with the carbon. Here's the intermediate coming in from the left. It's, as you see shortly, it's referred to as a secondary carbocation. Secondary because the carbon there, highlighted, has two alkyl groups attached to it. See how the bromine, or the bromide ion, comes in here, and the lone pair, which had been the bond between the H and the Br in hydrogen bromide, it's now being used here to form a bond with the carbon, which had the positive charge. The positive charge is no longer on the carbon because in gaining a share in that pair of electrons, it's effectively up an electron, so it's lost its positive charge. The bromide ion, it's lost its charge now, because in agreeing to share that pair of electrons with the carbon, it's effectively down an electron and it's lost its negative charge. So here's a summary of the mechanism. In the first slow step, it's known as the rate determining step, we get that intermediate formed. It's known as a secondary carbocation. Look at the carbon with a positive charge. It's got two alkyl groups, or it's connected to two C's. Makes that a secondary carbocation, and I'll discuss the stability of that shortly with you. And then in the fast step, see how the lone pair on the Br- ion is used to form a bond between it and the carbon. The carbon loses its positive charge because it gains a share in that lone pair and is effectively up an electron. The Br- loses its negative charge because in sharing that lone pair it's effectively down an electron, so it's back to neutral. So this involved an intermediate carbocation that was a secondary carbocation and the product 2-bromopropane. The hydrogen has gone on the left hand carbon. That left hand carbon, you notice, has two H's attached to it. And the bromine then ended up on the other carbon, so we got 2-bromopropane. Now we're going to look at the alternative mechanism. Remember, the H of the HBr might end up on the left-hand carbon or the right-hand carbon. So we've considered it going on to the left-hand carbon. Now let's consider it going the other way around. Going the H of the HBr, going on to the carbon on the right, that carbon atom having a H and a CH3 attached to it. Very, very similar mechanism. The key difference will be the structure of the intermediate carbocation, as you'll see. So again, we've got the HBr. Remember, it will be a polar molecule, so we should be showing a delta plus on the hydrogen and a delta minus on the bromine. And we've got that carbon-carbon double bond in the propene. There's four electrons associated with that carbon-carbon double bond, which means it's a region of high electron density. So there'll be an attraction between the delta positive hydrogen there and the carbon-carbon double bond. The curly arrow here shows the two electrons of the HBr, both of them go on to the bromine, which means that it has an extra electron, has taken the hydrogen's electron, and it'll have a minus charge. As the dash disappears, you'll notice that two dots, a lone pair, shows up on the bromine. Notice how a curly arrow showed the pi bond break, but look, it's breaking the other way around this time, and the hydrogen's therefore going on the right-hand carbon, and the positive charge is on the left-hand carbon instead. Down at the bottom there, we've created our bromide ion, Br- with the lone pair. A minus charge because the bromine has an electron that had belonged to. Now look at